Justin Heinzen, head women's basketball coach.
Sienna Stoya, assistant women's basketball.
Samantha Irvin, assistant women's basketball coach.
Duhawks starting the second half up 45-24.
First started coaching that I don't do now. I thought scheme was what much more important than it is now. What we're running, the plays we have, all that. While it's important, I'm not sure it's has the value that I thought it did back then. Just in how far you can go and where your team can go as a group. I think it's less about that stuff now.
I'd say a lot of it is Coach Jay, but we preach culture a lot on our team. So I think that helps a lot with it. We do it from the start. From day one that they walk on campus, we do a lot just working with them, getting our team culture right.
A lot of programs have one full-time coach and then a head coach. And we're lucky enough, from Sam's perspective, she works 60 hours a week and gets paid for probably 5 hours a week. So the sacrifice on that end is huge. But adding another full-time employee just doubles the work output that you can do. So I do feel it's a huge advantage in that part-time spot to get somebody who's going to be really committed. Obviously, using this as a springboard for her is really important too. But that's a game changer from a work perspective, and just what you can focus on and the amount of detail and manpower you have is totally changes. And Sienna, last year was her first year, and it's a COVID year, so welcome to college basketball in Dubuque, Iowa. But has transitioned a little bit better this year. Not that anything about last year was easy. Those two have fun together, I think, and have a good camaraderie built up. And it's a huge thing. Just the amount of that you can take off of a plate, adding 80 hours a week is a pretty big deal.
I think the players being open to come talk to us, and like the relationship that we build with the players is huge, because a lot of other programs, like they're not very, I've noticed they're not as close with players like off the court, so I think that's a huge part in how well we do on the court.
I would have to say, like, when I first started coaching, it was really awkward with the girls because I was so close in age, and I made myself distance, and now I don't do that. I make the relationship and have figured out that dynamic. Successful culture off the court makes a team successful.
I'd say work ethic.
I'd also say, like, the willingness to do anything, like, for the players.
The style of coaching on the court.
And then I think our relationship is good too. Like, being able to talk to each other as coaches is big.
You gotta have flexibility, because this thing, it changes on a dime.